Hello students, how are you? I hope everything is fine and great with you all. In today's session, we will have a poem. And before that, how many of you love visiting or going to a village? I know most of you will agree with my point. A village, beautiful life, greenery, fresh air, pure atmosphere, everything serene, right? Yes. But don't you and I, or let me put it in a better way, all of us, people residing in towns and cities, they miss village life, sincerely. The poem which we are going to read or learn is The Lake Isle of Innisfree from the book Bihar, and this poem is written by William Butler Yeats in the year 1888. Now, before I start my poem, let me say something about this poem. William Butler Yeats was born on June 13, 1865 in Ireland. He was a pillar of Irish literary establishment. He was a senator for the Irish Free State for 2 terms. And he has written n number of poems. Few of his poems, let me speak out. The Second Coming, Easter 1960, The Stolen Child, and obviously today's poem, The Lake Isle of Innisfree. Now, this poem, Lake Isle of Innisfree, was written by William Butler Yeats in the year 1888. What is Isle? Isle is an island, Innisfree. The poem gets its title from a very small, uninhabited, less number of people are there, that sits in a Loughgill. The place Loughgill, a lake in its home county of Sligo, Ireland. Actually, it's there still. It is also a reservoir. And this Innisfree is a serene place, calm, peaceful, quiet, away from hustle and bustle of town and city life. Okay. Now, please see the poem. It's in page number 53. The Lake Isle of Innisfree. Now, if I'm not wrong, check this number of stanzas. There are 3 stanzas and each stanza has 4 lines in it. And when a poem has 3 stanzas with 4 lines, we call it as quatrain. It is a quatrain. All total, 3 into 4, 12 lines. Now, let me read out the poem for you. I will arise and go now and go to Innisfree, and a small cabin built there of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hut for the honeybee, and live alone in the bee-loud glade. And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping from the vales in the morning to where the cricket sings. There's midnights all a glimmer and a moon purple glow, and evening full of the linnet wings. I will arise and go now, for always night and day. I hear the lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore, while I stand on the roadway, all the pavements grey. I hear it in a deep heart's core. This poem, the tone of the poet is feeling very unhappy. He is missing his childhood days. He is missing those days when he used to spend in the Innisfree. Now this poem tells that he is not in that village or in that place. He is in the town, the pavements you can see there. And his longing desire to go back to this place. I will arise and go now and go to Innsbruck. This one particular line tells, I will go now, says that he is vexed with the city life. He loves to go back. And what is his? What are his planning there? And I should, a small cabin, and he should build, and he would love to build a cabin there. And what kind of clay and wattle smith? What are wattle? Three branches of the trees. 9 bee rows will I have there, a hive for the honey bee. And he says, he would also make a hive for the honey bee, place for it, and live alone in the bee glade. Loud bee glade. What is bee loud glade? The humming of the bees. And I shall have some peace there. This line says that the poet is not happy. He is not living a peaceful life in the city. He needs some rest, he needs some peace. And what he says, how does he get the peace? For peace comes dropping from the wings of the morning to where the cricket sings. Yeah, nature is the best cure. Nature is a great medicine. It cures all type of diseases. He says, hey, you cannot get peace everywhere. You can get peace where your heart says, yeah, this is the place where I will have to be there. And the poet wants to move back to the place where he feels that he can have some peace, tranquility. So he feels, let me go back. And he says that he can get the peace as if from the snow. Morning snow. There midnight all a glimmer and a noon a purple glow. Now he is describing the day. How is he describing? In the morning, the falling of the snow. Midnight, all the glimmers. And in the noon, afternoon, he says, he describes afternoon, a purple glow, and evening, full of linnet wings, linnet, a glow warm. He says that, how beautifully he has described an entire day of in a village. The same day we have in the town and cities also, morning, afternoon, night, evening and night. But he says that in the village, the day has a different description. Morning, the fresh, where the birds, chirping of the birds, and the snow, the mist, the fog that falls from the leaves. And then it comes to the afternoon. Generally, the afternoons are not so soothing, or you can say, they are so bright that it makes us weak. Yes, but he says, afternoon, he describes the afternoon in the village, purple glow. There is some certain a glow, a brightness. And he comes to the evening, filled with the linnet, a small bird, grey bird. He says that you can see the birds, their wings flapping, their wings and flying here and there. And the midnight, generally the midnight's melancholy darkness comes. But he says here the midnights are so pleasant. So beautiful, happiness glimmers there. I will arise and go now. Poet says, now I cannot wait. I would love to go now. For always, night and day. He says, not for a day or a two, for always, forever. I would love to spend my entire life there. I hear the lake water lapping with the low sounds by the shore. Here hardly we can hear the lapping of the shore water. Water is polluted. Neither of that we can fresh air, stream, valleys. We don't find in the towns and cities. But he says the villages are filled with that. He says, I would love to hear those lapping of the sounds, lapping of the waves. When I stand on the roadway or on the pavement's grave, I hear it in the deep heart's core. The poet, where is the poet standing? And he is imagining all these things, standing on the pavement, town, city pavement. And he says that, standing on this pavement today, now, I could hear the lapping of the low sound waves. And that is deeply rooted in my heart core. And this is that he has a longing desire to go back to the place where he can get the peace, where you can get the tranquility, humdrums of the city life, hustle and bustle, crowds and all the traffics, the honks, the motor cars and the vehicles. He wants to move back to the place. Now, after this, what is the central theme of the poem? What is the central theme of the poem? Nothing. A longing desire. It is a nostalgic. What is a nostalgic? Something you recollect. Some memories which you have there, somewhere in the corner of your mind, you start recollecting nostalgia. So this is a nostalgia. And what is the rhyme scheme of the poem? The rhyme scheme of the poem is A, B, E, B.